And we don't give him a lot of notice. When there's a demand and a need, he's there setting up great sites. This is really exciting because this vaccine event is dedicated to law enforcement folks age 50 and up from Polk, Hardy, Highlands, and Lake counties. And we obviously are doing seniors first. That's been our top priority. We've done millions of seniors. We're one of the top performing states in vaccinating seniors. But when we got news that we were going to be getting the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, we were going to get 175,000. So we've gotten about 60,000. The rest is going to come in over the next few days. We looked at it and said, okay, this is an opportunity to get some of the folks who are really performing public service. So the cops, the sheriff's deputies, fire, teachers, those folks. So we're focusing on these drives on the 50 and up in those communities. And with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, one dose, doesn't need to be stored in really cold temperatures. It's a versatile vaccine. You come and do one of these, and it's great. You don't even have to worry about it going forward. And so we think Johnson & Johnson is going to be great for people in the workforce, and we want to make it available. And so that's what we're able to do. These folks here that wear the uniform, they don't have the ability to do a temperature check before they go serve the public. If there's an issue, they got to go deal with it. So they're in contact all the time. They're in a more high-risk profession than most of us are in. And so we want to make sure they know that we're standing with them. So this will do here 2,000 law enforcement personnel age 50 and up in all those counties. And we think that is going to be the vast, vast majority of those folks who qualify in that age group. Of course, this is not mandated. It's if people want it, they can take it. But this is a really, really neat first step, and we want to continue to do it. So we have statewide about 20,000 sworn law enforcement officers who are 50 or older. And so with this initial tranche of Johnson & Johnson, we can do every single one of them who wants it. We can do the fire 50 and up who wants it. And we can do all the people in the school system age 50 and up who want it. And so it's exciting to be able to complement the efforts that we've been doing on many of these other avenues. And here in Polk County, look, we're proud of our seniors first approach. We've done over 2.5 million seniors. We're doing a lot of shots every day. This week will be our best week that we've done since the pandemic started. We have well over 50% of all the seniors have gotten at least one shot. We also, though, look to see what's the progress looking on a county-by-county basis. And so if you look at St. John's County, for example, where I'm from, they have over 80% of the seniors have gotten at least one shot. Here in Polk County, it's about 43%. And so we believe this is something, focusing on counties that may be below the state average is a good thing. So Andy had set up a senior community at one of the mobile home parks, I guess a couple days ago, right?
Yes, sir.
So is that done, 3 days?
Yes, sir.
So we did thousands of vaccines there.
It was almost 1,700, I believe.
1,700 in a senior community. We're also going to have an announcement next week about expanding retail pharmacy footprint in Polk County, and so stay tuned for that. And again, trying to get the numbers up among seniors, but then also complementing it with the law enforcement. One of the things we just announced yesterday was a rural program. If you look at the 10 lowest coverage rates for seniors in terms of vaccinations, the majority of those are rural counties. Now, we have some rural counties that are 75%. Lafayette is the highest in the state. I think they're 82, 83% coverage. But we have some Highlands, Glades, Levy, Putnam, Dixie, and Gilcrest that are in the 30s. And we think we can make a difference there. So we're partnering with Health Hero, which is a provider we've used for past immunizations campaigns. And they are going to get additional vaccine, and then they're going to strategically deploy that. If you have an existing pod that could be plussed up, maybe you do that. If you need to do a house of worship, like we've done all across the state, maybe you do that. If you need to find a senior community, like we've done across the state, maybe you do that. So they're going to be able to have flexibility to put those vaccines in the areas that are going to make the most impact. But I think on the rural counties, if you do this and you're able to have some good throughput, you can increase those numbers very, very quickly, because you're talking about a relatively small numbers of shots compared to like a Palm Beach or a Broward or a Miami-Dade. And it's interesting, if you look at kind of the state around, you got some massive counties that have just done fantastic. Palm Beach is almost 67% coverage for seniors getting at least one shot. Broward and Duval, massive counties, they're over 60%. of seniors that have gotten it. Miami-Dade starting to go up. They're well over 50%. I think they're going to hit 60% very soon. We put CVS, Navarro Pharmacies, dozens of those stores. They're doing 100 to 200 shots a day at each one of those. So you're going to continue to see more with that. We also have done, we have now six permanent sites at areas that are underserved: Edward Waters College in Jacksonville, FAMU, Kissimmee Community Center, Broward College, Oak Grove Park, and Overton Youth Center. The last two are both in Miami-Dade. We think that those are important. We're going to continue to support those. Now, though, if you look at the Publix footprint, the CVS footprint, Walmart, we've got 12 Walgreens so far. There's going to be more. 81 CVSs, mostly in Miami-Dade, but we're going to announce an expansion of that very soon. 730 Publix pharmacies throughout the state of Florida are offering shots for senior citizens, and then 119 Walmart and Sam's Clubs, and 43 Winn-Dixie. So 52 counties out of 67 have at least one retail pharmacy option, and many of those counties, particularly more populous counties, they have multiple options. So here in Polk, we have 24 Publix pharmacies. You'd expect to have that in Polk County, given Publix is headquartered here. Three Walmarts, two Sam's Clubs, and two Walgreens, all offering vaccines. You can sign up online, Publix.com/COVID vaccine. I think the next window for Publix will be Monday morning at 7 a.m. We also have Walmart.com/COVID vaccine, Sam's Club.com/COVID, and then Walgreens.com. You click COVID vaccine information to be able to do that. We've done houses of worship all across the state, dozens and dozens of churches, predominantly African American churches. We actually had the Biden administration had Jared Moskowitz on a nationwide call saying, okay, Florida's really doing well with the seniors. Have you gotten it into all these communities, and specifically with the houses of worship? So people are actually looking at Florida as best practices with partnering with local churches, getting folks in those communities to come out and get the vaccine, and we're proud of those efforts. And Jared and the Department of Emergency Management, they've worked with every single member of the Legislative Black Caucus, have put some of these sites in most of their districts, and continue to work hard to be able to expand offerings. We have 87 permanent sites throughout the state and 25 senior communities we've done. We were just at a top of the world in Marion County. Nice drive-through site that they set up. Seniors were very happy with that, and we want to continue to do it. And then finally, FEMA. We have four FEMA sites in Florida. They're providing additional vaccine, which is great, and Jacksonville, Orlando, Miami, and Tampa. I know Wednesday, the first day, they did about 50% of their allotted shots. I think yesterday was a little bit better, and so we'll see how that goes. They're not really doing like an online sign-up. They're kind of going to selected communities, knocking on doors, asking people to come get vaccines. So it's a little bit different, but it may be one that ends up being effective. We'll have to wait and see. So we're not getting any more Johnson & Johnson for, I think, two more weeks. So this 175,000 is it for the next 2 weeks. But then we think the production will ramp back up, and then we'll start getting more and more J&J. We're trying to ascertain the demand for J&J. Some people were denigrating J&J a couple weeks ago. I think that was a mistake. J&J is very effective. Now we're finding there's a lot of people that want the J&J. So we want to go ahead and make sure that that's available. You're going to start to see more vaccine in private doctor's offices because they're in the communities. You're going to see even more retail pharmacies as we get more vaccines coming in. I think what we find is it's fine to do a drive-through site at like a sports stadium or do some of these things, but if you can get it in places that people are comfortable with in their communities, people go to a pharmacy, they go to a doctor, they go to some of these things. It ends up, I think, increasing the efforts to be able to get shots in people's arms. So, but we're excited for this. When we called Sheriff Judd and asked if he would kind of help pilot the first go at this with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, he never hesitated. And so we're going to be doing these with other law enforcement agencies throughout the state of Florida in the coming days, in the coming weeks. And so as we're looking at this, seniors first, obviously, because we had this extra vaccine, we could kind of get into the 50-plus law enforcement, teachers, fire. And so that's really going to continue on next week. After that, we are going to be looking to reduce the age, and I'll have an announcement on that hopefully next week. But 60, 65 plus has been our target. We're well over a majority. I think we're going to end up with hundreds of thousands more very soon as well because of the way we're going. And so at that point, if the demand is softening, we can then go and then get some of the folks who are 60 to 65 and get them in. And then we'll move it down to 55 and do it. But that's really going to be the approach that we're going to be following going forward. So I think all in all, having a new vaccine on board, very exciting. We anticipate more supply in the future, and we'll continue working with all these folks to be able to distribute that to the folks who want it, particularly our elderly population. I want to give Grady an opportunity to come up and say a few things.
Thank you very much, Governor. It's exciting to have you here with us in our shop today. And this is all about community. The community together can put this pandemic down by putting shots in arms. Our governor has been fantastic during a very difficult, very trying time. Think about it. He didn't shut Florida down. Kids are in school. And we're not going to suffer like some other states are because our kids are not going to lose a year of education. And that's a real possibility. We're not going to have to deal with maybe the social effects or the mental health effects of being quarantined and by themselves. A lot of that will never be measured. But I can tell you this. This governor said we're going to be responsible. We're going to respect this virus. But more than anything, we're going to come through it. And now it's up to the community. As this vaccine rolls into the state of Florida, please get your shot. Because when we get our shots, herd immunity kicks in. We're already seeing profits from that. Do you know, think about it. Our crime rate's at a 49-year low. That's no accident. It doesn't just happen. It happens because of great leadership, and that's what we have with Governor DeSantis. When he looked our population over and he saw that we have a significant amount, I think 30% more senior citizens than average, he said, they're the most vulnerable, they're first. He made decisions based upon science and evidence and who is most vulnerable to be the sickest from this horrible, horrible COVID. And that's the decisions he made. He didn't practice politics. He practiced leadership. He practiced administrative government, and he did the job that he was hired to do, and he continues every day. I would like to see us get the maximum number of people with a vaccine very, very quick. Now, I know there's some that are waiting back. They're not concerned. They're not sure if it's good. And I've heard the stories, and I have read the conspiracy theories. You know, I've seen everything. We don't know the end results. Oh, my gosh, what's going to happen? In 10 years, will my ears fall off? Well, quite frankly, I'd rather be alive in 10 years with no ears than dead in 10 years with two good ears. So I'm not sure what that's all about. Listen to the doctors. Listen to the science. I've not found one physician, one medical doctor yet that I've interacted with that has said anything other than get the shot as soon as you can. So, Governor, thank you for providing leadership for the entire state of Florida, for looking out for the best interests of everyone in the community. I got my shot. It was a wonderful thing. And I appreciate everyone that's here today that came here to work, because when you put shots in arms, ladies and gentlemen, you're helping save lives and protect people from very serious illness. So God bless everyone. All right. Thank you, Governor.
Thank you. I think it's also worth pointing out some of the numbers that we're getting on the economic front. So we had a unemployment rate registered for December at 6.1%. I think many of you know that. That was less than the national average, which shows, I think, Florida's strength, because we don't have our cruise ships going. We don't have full tourism. I don't have people coming from international like we used to. And so we knew as soon as all those are allowed, the unemployment will go down even more. But they just did the revisions, and they had been revising our unemployment rate up. Even before COVID, the initial would be revised slightly upward. We still had low unemployment. Then when COVID hit, they were revising it up. For example, in June, they did an upward revision of 1.3% from 10.3 to 11.6. Well, for December, we were initially 6.1. They've revised it down to 5.1% unemployment for the month of December. And so that's better than the national average. We are probably 20, 30, 40, maybe even 50% lower than some of these other states, a lot of the lockdown states that have 7, 8, 9% unemployment. And so we think that that's a lot of positive momentum. We want to continue to build off of that. But then if you look at the tax revenue, remember 9, 10 months ago, they were saying, oh my gosh, they're not going to have any money. It's going to be all this, it's crazy. So the February 21, what we're looking at for the actual receipts of sales tax, for example, 10% higher receipts than what was forecasted. The documentary stamp tax, which is a for real estate transactions, 40% higher revenue coming in than what was estimated for February. And these estimates were revised higher than what we had 9 or 10 months ago. And so you see all this stuff coming in faster. Corporation filing fees, listen to this, 74% higher than what was forecast. And that's because people think they can start a business in Florida. Their businesses are getting shut down still in some of these other states. They're coming here, or people already here are looking to do things. So I think that those are really good economic indicators. And yes, having the kids in school is very important. Doing these shots, very important as well. But we also got to have people to be able to put food on the table. And you can't do that if you're locking people down. You got to lift them up. That's what we're doing. And I think this momentum is good. And I can tell you this. The seniors, when they're getting their shots and they feel really good, some of them really want to go out and do a lot of stuff. Now, people have been responsible. Not like everyone's been in their home the whole time. But I do think that it does give people kind of an extra bounce in their step. And they're going to want to be out and about doing some of the things that they used to do before they had to worry about COVID. So all in all, I think if we can continue on the senior first, get all the seniors who wanted vaccinated, obviously do things like this where we can help law enforcement and those key people. We want to be able to do that. But, man, I think we're going to be in much better shape than people thought we would be if you go back 11 months from now. So happy to be here, and I'm happy that the state of Florida is using J&J. It's going in the arms, and we're going to keep it up as long as they keep sending us the supply. Anyone got any questions?
Thank you, Governor. This is for Orlando TV station. They're asking, do you have plans to allow all Florida counties to allow teachers of no matter what age to access to the shot?
So what we're doing, all the state stuff is going to focus on the 50-plus, any school employee, any law enforcement, and any fire. Now, the federal government has come and said, you can do. So the pharmacy program, those federal sites and all that, obviously the federal government has decreed that. But we are going to focus our efforts on the elderly and then the 50 up for the key personnel. And the reason for that is nationwide, 95.7% of all COVID-related mortality is age 50 or higher. And so if you have a shot, and you have an 80-year-old who still needs one, to give it to someone that's 22 or 23, that's not the best use. Now, having said that, if you want to go to these sites or the federal site or the CVS or all that, federal government has said you can do that. But our efforts are still going to be focused on the elderly because that's where the risk is. That's how you reduce mortality and save lives. And we're getting close. I mean, we're doing a lot of vaccine now. We have much better supply this week than we did last week or the week before. So we're getting close, but man, it's harder for seniors to navigate some of this stuff. And my concern would be to just have a lot of tech-savvy people who are young and healthy jumping the line over the seniors would not be, I think, the best public health strategy.
Yes. Sarah Walsh with the Letter. Is this the first site for law enforcement officers in the state, or are there other events across the state happening today?
So this is the first one with J&J. Now, we have done, I mean, I know, I don't know if we did one with Sheriff Judd, but when we did the 65 and up, we worked with a lot of law enforcement. They said, any of your elderly employees, you know, we make sure we did it. We did the same. A lot of the counties did work with us with the teachers. But this is the first one to use the J&J, and it'll be interesting to see the response people have to it. My hope is that J&J is something that people really like, and then we do it. And then when you start getting into the workforce, man, you send that J&J, I mean, you could send it directly to different places All you got to do is put it in the refrigerator, and so it's easy to do. So I think this is really an exciting day for the state of Florida to be able to get the Johnson & Johnson vaccine shots into people's arms. And what we're going to work on doing is doing a senior community with the J&J and seeing offering that to seniors and seeing what the uptake is going to be on that. I've heard different things. Some seniors have just always said they wanted Pfizer or Moderna. But then I have other seniors who are like, you know what, I've actually been waiting for Johnson & Johnson. I could have gotten a Pfizer, but I want to wait because I just want to get one shot. So it's interesting how different people have different views on it, but we want to be able to do it. So this will not be the last. We're going to be doing a lot of this next week in different parts of the state, and we're just going to keep working with those folks who protect us.
Governor, a little off topic, what's your reaction to the inspector report about the Florida unemployment?
I haven't had a chance to review it yet. So we obviously put that into practice. I thought it was important for them to do it. And so, you know, we've been bouncing around. We've been in Ocala. We've been in Tallahassee. We have this. So I will definitely take a look at it this weekend and get back to you.
I have a question. So are you all pinpointing law enforcement officers in the rural counties first as far as the distribution of Johnson & Johnson? Is that how it's working?
Well, no. So this particular site, are these counties, the rural, and then Polk, there's 700,000 people in Polk. It's a pretty populous county. And then we also going to work. So the way we thought about it was Miami, Tampa, Orlando, and Jacksonville have these FEMA sites. They are getting Johnson & Johnson too. So what we've advised the law enforcement there is to maybe work on those sites. Then the other counties that are sizable, like Polk, that don't have the FEMA, then we would say, let's go Polk, let's go Broward, let's go Palm Beach, Pinellas, Lee, and all those. So I think that's what you're going to do. And then what happens is if you're in a place like Lee County, you can invite some of the other folks in some of the neighboring counties. And so that's what we're looking to do. So we'll be rolling that out over the next few days, but I think it'll be effective. And I think they did a really good job. I mean, you know, anytime we tell Andy we need his support, it just always ends up happening. I mean, I don't know how they do it because it's a lot of moving parts here. But these folks who are working on these shots, I mean, I see some of these smiling faces at all over the state. I mean, the same folks just bounce around and they're really working hard. So, but look, you're never going to be able to potentially have as much of an impact as you'll be able to have right now with doing this. I mean, we were just at on top of the world, and there were seniors that were crying that they were finally getting shots. Very, very emotional, very personal for a lot of people. And yeah, you do different things and you build a road or you do this, and that's all important stuff. But man, this stuff, I think really, people really appreciate it. So thank you guys for what you're doing. And we will be back. Maybe we'll be back here to sign the anti-rioting bill in a couple months. So, okay, we'll see you guys. Thanks, guys. Yeah, thanks for all your hard work.